Hey, what's up guys? So today I'm going to show you a couple of things from my new book. One is a really cool sort of card location effect that I call Sapphire. The other one is a nice spectator shuffle deck Ace production. And I call that exquisite because it is exquisite. So the reason I'm doing both of these is because the first one leads into the second one. So it's sort of like a good routine lesson. And the cool thing about Sapphire is that the principle can be used for so many different things. You can use it as a force, a key card location, or a holdout, or whatever you want to do with it. But let's get into it. Do me a favor, take the deck and start dealing cards face down into a pile. When you feel like there's enough, maybe a few cards, more and more, it doesn't really matter. When you're done, give the deck a shuffle and then deal some more. And whenever you want to, stop and start a new pile over here, right? So do that, stop and shuffle anytime you want. And try to make two piles of about even cards. So stop and shuffle, deal cards anywhere you want to until the cards are all gone, all right? So, go ahead and pick up any pile you want, maybe this pile here. Look at the top card, all right? And make sure nobody sees it. In fact, we'll show you so I can't see it, all right? So cut that pile and put it on top of the other pile. And I'll go ahead and give the whole thing another cut like this, all right? So look, you shuffle the whole deck, made two piles, really randomize the cards, right? What I'll do is I'll try to get a sort of sense of what your card might be, all right? Focus on your card. I think I might have an idea of what it might be. All right, so you know what, I think it might be a black card, maybe this one right here. I don't know, it might be it. Yeah, I think that's the right one. For the first time, what was your card? The King of Spades. Yeah, that's it right there. Now I know what you're thinking, that's one card, but can you find more than one card? And the answer is yes. All right, so look, you shuffle these cards, right? What I'll try to do is try to find not one, not two, not three, but four cards. All right, look, my shuffle deck, here we go. Let's see if I can do this right. Maybe this one, there's an ace. Let's see, I think another one, there's another ace. And let's see, maybe just say stop anytime right here. That's one, two, three, four aces. All right, so what you do is you have the four aces on top of the deck as your setup and you are good to go. All right, so you hand them the deck and what you want them to do is deal two piles of cards, but one of the piles has to have the four aces on the bottom. So the way you do that is you ask them to start dealing cards face down one at a time until they want to stop. And in fact, anytime you want to stop, get the deck a shuffle, right? So they do that and you can deal in groups if you want to. And the main thing you want to happen here is that the four aces go down to first, or after that, they can do anything. All right, so you can say stuff like, anytime you want, just stop and shuffle, and anytime, just start a new pile to the other side, all right? So they do that, deal some cards, stop and shuffle anytime, put cards anywhere you want to when you feel like there's enough. So here's the cool thing about this, you can have them pick up any pile, so if they pick up the one that doesn't have the aces, you have them look at the top card here. So they do that, and that's the three. So then you have them pick up the other pile and put it on top, which puts the aces on top of their card. All right, if they pick up the pile with the aces, have them look at the top card of that pile, which in this case will be the seven. And now here is a little different. You have them cut this pile in half like this and like that. So they take half the cards, slap them on top, which puts the aces on top of their card. Like this, and then in any case, have them give the deck, the whole deck, a couple of cuts like this, and that retains the aces on top of their card either way. So you just pause for a moment before picking up the deck and you say, look, just focus on your card. I'm trying to get a sense of what your card might be in the deck. All right, so just focus on it. I think it might have a certain feeling of what it might be. All right, so you say all that before you even pick up the deck. All right, so you pick it up, start running through. Oh, in this case, it's just right here on the bottom, so let's pretend it's not, all right? So what you do is you start spreading through, making sure they can't see it, right? So what you're doing here is looking for the aces, and whatever card is on the bottom of the aces will be their card. So what you need to do is put it on the table and then make these aces be on top of the deck, all right? So put that there. I think that might be it. Spread over the aces. Yeah, that might be the one. I think that's the right one. And then put that down so the aces are now on top of the deck. Really, the more acting you can do is better. You don't want to be robotic. Let's see. Yep, there it is right there. And then put the deck down. The more authenticity you put into it, it will make a better trick. So for the first time, what was your card? Seven of spades. Now, that might be a cool trick. And some people might say, well, that's a good trick. But can you find two cards or maybe three or four? And the answer is yes. And now you're in a good position to do the ace trick because they shuffle the deck, they cut the deck, but unbeknownst to them, you have the four aces on top of the deck. So what we can do here is while you're talking, get the deck another riffle shuffle. So look, what I'll try to do is try to find four cards. All right, so here's the ace cutting sequence. So what you're going to do is the triple false cut by Jerry Griffin, and here's what it looks like. So the cut just looks like this. I think everybody knows it, but with the swivel, I think you're familiar with how that works, right? But if you're not, briefly, you just cut about a third of the deck into your hand like this, and immediately lift those about half up with your finger, and then put everything in this hand, holding with the ring, middle, and index, right? So from there, take the middle packet, boom, top packet, boom, and then slap the rest on top, and that's the false cut. But for the production, what you'll do is lift about half, right? And then put them here, and then do the swing cut, do the false cut like normal, only when you get to here, with the last packet, do a slip cut, all right? So to produce the ace, do the slip cut, moving forward, and then turn your wrist and drop it on top the table. So the other aces are on top of here. So what you'll do is a Frank Thompson cut to produce the other ace like this. So swing over about maybe half of these on top of here without holding it right because there's the aces right there. And then from there, swing over about half of these, keep a break and put these on the table and then take everything above the break, slap them on top of there and then produce this ace how you did that one. So come over like this and then them over face up on the table. Now the other two aces are again right here, so what you can do is a slip shuffle, and like this, they say stop anytime, and then when they do, put these on top of here and there, produce both aces at once, boom and boom, and there is your ace production. And this is just nice routining because the first trick sets you up for this ace production, and the ace production sets you up for a lead-in for a four ace trick, like an ace assembly. So, you know, you can do a whole set with just the four aces on top of the deck, ready to go. You can also use Sapphire just by itself as a standalone force. So, let's say our force card is the King of Diamonds, you want that second from the top, ready to go. Alright, so that can be any card, it doesn't matter. So, same thing, deal into a pile whenever you want to stop, shuffle the deck. Anytime you want to start a new pile, and they do this until, you know, there's two piles, and there's no cards left. Alright, so from here, they can pick up any pile, and let's say they choose this pile here. If they choose the one without the force card, I have them put it, just slap them on top of the deck. Alright, if they choose this one, say, look, what I want you to do is... just in case I saw a card or anybody else saw a card, just burn the bottom card, all right? Also burn the top card. So they do that, and now they peek at the bottom card, which is the force card, and they slap it on top. Again, same thing over here. If they do this, if they pick this one, they slap it on top. Do me a favor, just in case anybody saw anything, burn the bottom card, also burn the top card, peek at the bottom card, and then shuffle the deck. All right, so I hope you liked this trick, and I hope you really learned something new from this video, and thanks for watching. Until next time, happy practicing. I love you guys.